New pocket door.
Just wait. Okay, we're streaming.
Huh? We're live.
How's the new AP doing at the
house? Mr. Buckley. It's a high
five. Okay, everybody ready? We are live on our live stream. Okay, so we'll call the meeting back to order. And we will resume the public session by starting with the Pledge of Allegiance. Will you all please rise? And Dr. Griffin, would you lead us in the pledge?
Of course. Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. All right, good evening, everybody. How are you? Everybody well? All right, so just want to remind everybody of the emergency exits. In the event of an emergency, please leave in an orderly fashion through these exits. Also remind you that this is a smoke-free school district. Smoking is not permitted in the building or anywhere on the school grounds. Just take a moment to notice the exit to the rear of the room and also to my right and to your left. All right, with that, we have the first item on the agenda, the board consent agenda, item number C. That would be the treasurer's report, the minutes of October 24th, and the student appeal. So that would be items number 1 through 3. We need a motion and a second to approve. Ms. Malin, then by Ms. Hunt. Any discussions? Seeing no discussion, so you're ready to vote on those items. All those in favor of item C 1 through 3, please raise your hands. Thank you. Put them down. Seeing all hands raised, the motion passes unanimously. Next, we have communications and announcements, and we'll turn it over to the superintendent, Dr. Gianni.
Thank you, President Felice. I'd like to start off communications and announcements with some special recognition of some of our high school students. Here to make introductions for these recognitions is our high school principal, Mr. Hogan. Mr. Hogan,
thank you. Good evening. It's my pleasure to recognize four of our high school graduating seniors to you tonight. This past October, there were more than 300 residents attended the town of Brookhaven's 5th annual Hispanic Heritage Night celebration, hosted by Brookhaven's Hispanic Advisory Board. During the annual celebration of Hispanic culture, 64 Hispanic and Latino high school seniors from 13 school districts throughout Brookhaven were honored for maintaining a cumulative GPA of 95 or higher. I'm pleased to present four of our graduating seniors who were recognized by the Hispanic Advisory Board for this outstanding achievement. It's a pleasure to have each of them represent Belport High School in South Country in such a positive fashion. So as I call your name, if you would please come forward. First, Chelsea Argueta. Chelsea was looking to go to Binghamton University in the fall as a biology major. Henry Chiligao. Also looking to attend Binghamton University in the fall and study mechanical engineering. Congratulations, Henry. Evelise Diaz. Evelise is looking to go to Stony Brook University in the fall as a biomedical major. Congratulations to you. And last but not least, Catherine Fuentes Velasco. Catherine's looking to go to Stony Brook University and someday become an entrepreneur as you study business. Congratulations once again, and thank you to their parents and family members for joining us this evening.
And we have some.
Turn this way.
I think
They stayed in water.
Did they? We have Chelsea first. Congratulations to you. And Henry, congratulations. Evelyn. Congratulations. Okay, congratulations all of you.
Thank you.
Take a quick picture.
Do any parents want to come up?
You want to come up? You want to come up, Nate?
Take a picture.
You come up and take a picture.
She wanted to be in the picture.
Congratulations, guys.
Congratulations. Good luck with your studies.
Thank you so much.
Come back and see us at 20. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And moving along with recognitions, I had the pleasure of attending Belport High School Center of Excellence Club Induction Ceremony and Dinner last Thursday, along with President Felice and Vice President Hunt. It's a very nice ceremony where President Felice and our congressman actually were guest speakers at the event. The Center of Excellence Club provides students with opportunities and resources to explore college as a realistic, attainable post-high school option. Congratulations are in order to the 30 students recognized, along with thank yous to advisors Amy Alucci and Nicole Caleo for organizing the event. And of course, the dinner was catered by our own Belport Culinary Program students, and as always, they certainly outdid themselves. Moving on, in an effort to proactively address unfounded threats sometimes made, this week, high school students, as well as middle school students, are viewing and discussing a school threats video created by Suffolk County Police Department. This is a very informative video. It's being shown through grade level assemblies, and it is also available for parents and the community on our website under Parent Resources for your information. Congratulations are in order to all participants of the Pride Cup Challenge last week. With great pride, Team Belport High School won Pride Cup Round 1, the Volleyball Challenge, while Team Frank P. Long sported the best uniforms. Congratulations are to all participants in Pride Cup Round 2, Jeopardy, scheduled for Thursday, January 10th. And finally, Regent Roger Tills will be visiting the school district tomorrow. He will be visiting classrooms and meeting the children at both Frank P. Long Intermediate School, as well as Brookhaven Dual Language Magnet School. So we look forward to meeting and touring him through those two buildings. And that is all the communications announcements I have, President Felice.
All right, thank you very much. Okay, so the communications and announcements for the trustees. And I'm drawing a blank on your name right now. Why is that happening?
Carly,
of course. Carly, would you like to begin?
Yes, please. The first marking period ended this past Friday, and I think it is safe to say that it was the start to a very successful school year. On October 26th, the Student Council ran Trick or Treat Street, also known as Safe Halloween, at the high school. Kids from every elementary school in our district enjoyed the activities, treats, and excitement that this night had to offer. The food drive run by Supo is in full swing, and we have received hundreds of food items to provide for over 30 less fortunate families in our community, with meals for Thanksgiving next week. The food drive will also continue throughout November and December to provide more meals to the community and our district during the holiday season. Student Council has come up with many fundraising ideas for the LEAD conference in Washington, D.C. this February, and we are looking to narrow down our options to raise money for this trip.
Very good, thank you.
Carly, I don't want to put you on the spot, but I'm going to, and I know that you don't have a lunch period. But did you have an opportunity to go by and see the new furniture?
I did, actually. I stopped by today to fill up my water bottle, and it's very nice. I love the booths and the table decorated. Very nice.
And so the final furniture, well, we're still waiting for one countertop with charging stations in it for the senior kids. back. But the round tables with the Clipper logos came in. It looked pretty nice.
And it's the east cafeteria?
Is that east?
So it's one of the main floor. Yeah,
okay. As soon as you walk in.
Yep.
Yeah. Thank you, and I'm sorry.
Okay, Mrs. Santa?
Oh, I just wanted to send out praise to all of the students who were involved at the high school production of Moon Over Buffalo. In fact, we have one of our stars of the show here, Henry. It was once again a great production, and I want to thank the faculty that's involved with helping our students put on such enjoyable and professional productions as we do, and I know many people are looking forward to the musical, which will be in February. I personally am looking forward to parent-teacher conferences, which are tomorrow evening at the high school, so if parents are not aware, you can sign up online through the district website. It's the Canyon Creek link that you can find there to schedule. And also, it's hard to believe, but looking forward to the holidays. December 18th and 20th will be the musical performances at the high school. So all of our performing groups will be performing on those days, again, December 18th and 20th. So if you do have some time, the concerts are always an enjoyable evening. So I hope to see more people there. Thank you.
What is the musical this year?
The musical this year is Rent.
Nothing for you, Mr. Pacini?
I was glad Carly mentioned the Safe Street Trick-or-Treat. I would have forgotten it. I haven't gone in a couple years, and I'm glad that I had a minute to get up there, even if it was for the last half hour. It was really well done, better than the last time I was there. So just my daughter and I, we had a real nice time. So kudos to everybody who puts that on, and especially the staff. I was impressed to see how many teachers I saw there on their own time volunteering for that. Kids really enjoyed it. I know my daughter had a great time. And the classrooms were done with the activities very, very well, and better than I remember in the past. My daughter's still a little young to go in the haunted house section, so we had to quickly scamper through that section where it's a little dark and the kids are screaming in there. I didn't get to see Moon Over Buffalo. It's hard, and I was asking about the High School Musical. It's tough when you have young kids. I like the way I had Shrek and Sound of Music the last couple of years. We'll have to skip Rent and look for the middle school production. But some congratulations on some successful seasons for our sports teams, all of our sports teams. But I know we had at least three in the playoffs, and unfortunately didn't go as well as planned. The boys' soccer team lost in the first round, the volleyball team lost in the first round, and the football team lost in the first round. I don't know if I missed anybody else that made the playoffs, but I think that was it. I know the golf team had a pretty successful, I think they had one kid make the counties or two. But either way, congratulations to everybody, a great season, and the teams who made the playoffs. It's unfortunate it ended the way it did, but it was a good season nonetheless. So, that's it.
All right, Dr. Griffin.
I too had the chance to enjoy Moon Over Buffalo. And great job, Henry. Your George was wonderful, and your cast. Please send all of my praise. A fantastic ensemble. Really worked well together. Timing was right on the money, and really captured a lot of the humor from Ludwig's writing. And a special congratulations to Susan Hartman and Barbara Gallagher, the directors, who did a phenomenal job with a very talented cast. A great way to spend an evening at Belport High School. So thank you so much for your hard work. I know it's a tremendous undertaking to put a show together. So that was a great night. And I had a great day at the Brookhaven Elementary School, where I had the opportunity to read to Miss Missick's third grade class, where we read The Pout Fish. And they were one of the most outstanding classes I have ever seen, regardless of grade level. Engaged, funny, focused. Congratulations to Miss Missick for really leading a great group of kids. I want to give a quick shout out to them. I told them they're going to be famous because they're going to be mentioned at the board meeting. So Christian, Colleen, Natalie, Matthew, Jason, Olivia, Julia, Madison, Amber, Mia, Connor, Kimberly, Kellen, Layla, Tylea, Tyler, Jesse, Ronnie, and Kyle. Awesome job. You guys are amazing. So I've had a great time with them, and it just reinforces everything we know. When you actually get in the classrooms, Bellport, South Country Schools, they're amazing with great teachers and amazing kids. We're really, really lucky to be here. So thank you.
Great. Thank you. And Mr. Nix?
I just want to thank the BTA for having myself, Vice President Hunt, and President Felice at the annual mentor and new teacher dinner about 2 weeks ago. It was a lovely time. Also, give a shout out to the students and faculty of Moonover Buffalo. The arts will always hold a special place in my heart at Bellport. And I look forward to seeing Rent when I found out that that was the musical. I was sort of surprised, but in a good way. So I think it's great. congrats to our four students recognized tonight. It's just a beautiful thing to see your achievements. And I wish you all the success in the future.
Kudos to the BTA for the mentoring dinner. It was nice. It was great seeing so many and talking to so many new teachers that really, I think, are going to have a great fit here. I think just in speaking to them, they're excited. We have something special here at South Country, so I'm excited. It was good talking to them all, so I'm wishing them all good luck. The Center of Excellence, Thursday was, I was a little bit late, but I did catch the induction part. They got pins and everything. I think it was a very proud moment for the students and the parents for them to show some great leadership coming up. And kudos to the four students that just received awards from Hispanic Heritage Month. Very good. Very proud.
Okay. All right. Okay, so my report, just briefly. As was already mentioned, I did enjoy the mentors' dinner sponsored by the BTA, and also witnessed the excitement of our new group of teachers and the principals who were there to guide them and their mentors to guide them, and we enjoyed a very nice evening with many of the directors, and speaking about their programs and initiatives and what we can expect for Bellport in the months to come. So that was a very rewarding night, and thanks again. With Mr. Nix, I attended the Transformative Educational Development Services Awards on the 27th of October, where our own Vice President Hunt was awarded the Warrior Award. And if you had a chance to read her bio, you would know why she was designated as a warrior. And we were very proud to be in her company. We're very proud to support this organization. One of our students, Mr. Skelly, who we recognized last month, was also given an award that month. And a lot of tears were being shed that day with pride because of the well-deserving members who were recognized. So it was a wonderful event, and we're glad we could be there to support you. Also attended the last home football game of the season. That the rainout game was postponed to the 28th on the Sunday. So they played on the soccer field, which is the turf field. A number of people, which I've already shared with Dr. Gianni. And of course, it's a budget issue, but the PA system there is not as they would like to see it. And that was evident when the visiting team had a better PA system than we did with what they brought in. So something to consider and to look at and see if there's some room for improvement. But again, you know, hats off to a wonderful season to all of our sports team, and especially the football game. It's a little disconcerting being on the sidelines and so close to the hits on those teams, but they do a remarkable job, and hats off to the coaches and the administrative staff there for teaching those kids so well. And then finally, as Dr. Gianni and Ms. Hunt already mentioned, the Center of Excellence. I also attended that event, and as Dr. Gianni mentioned, I was invited to be a guest speaker, and what Dr. Gianni read about the Center of Excellence is what I was provided with beforehand to, as a guideline to what to say to these students to inspire them to stay on the career track that they are planning for themselves with reaching the goal of a four-year college. And so I just spoke from a personal experience, and I got a very, very wonderful thank you letter from Mr. Favell, who oversees, what is his role to oversee the Center of Excellence?
Assistant principal and oversees the advisors.
The advisors of Center of Excellence. And I was, I was very appreciative of his acknowledgement. It was a great night. Mr. Hogan was the master of ceremonies, and it truly was a rewarding experience, and got to speak with a lot of the students and their parents. So invited them to come and tell us and keep us up to date with how they're progressing. And also, if some invitations could be extended to the Board of Education on when they meet so that we could check in on how they're doing. And certainly we want to know if they need additional support that we can be able to offer to them. So thank you again for the invitation. It was a wonderful evening. And that's all I have. So we'll move on to public commentary. Are there any cards? No cards, so then I won't read public commentary. At this point, we have items for discussion and action. The independent auditor's report.
Yes, thank you. Our first item for discussion is our independent auditor's report for school year ending June 30th, 2018. With us this evening to present their findings is Mr. Mike Leone of Cullen and Donowski, who are our external auditing firm. Mr. Leone.
Thank you, everyone. Good evening. As Dr. Gianni mentioned, my name is Michael Leone. I'm the principal, the external audit firm, Cullen Donowski. Been on the engagement a number of years. Here to report on the financial results for year 30, 2018. Before I do that, I'd like to just express my gratitude to the board and the district for the cooperation during the audit and for engaging us. As you may or may not know, if you ever undergo an audit, it's an involved process. There's a lot of cooperation, and it can be time-consuming here for a number of weeks. So again, we appreciate all the cooperation that we received. So we're reporting on the June 30th, 2018 financial statements. The district is required to have an annual audit every year. That's required by the New York State Education Department. Upon completion of that, the district submits their reports to both the New York State Education Department as well as the New York State Comptroller's Office. For the fiscal year ended June 30, 2018, we issued what is known as an unmodified opinion on our audit report. So what does that mean? That means that we conducted our audit in accordance with our professional standards, and those standards require that we plan and perform the audit to obtain reasonable assurance that the financial statements are free of material misstatement. Clearly, an unmodified opinion indicates that. In addition to that, the district is also subject to government auditing standards. That means that they need to comply with laws and regulations as it relates to reserves and various other factors. If we had any significant deficiencies or material weaknesses, we would be required to report that to you. We're happy to report that we have none. We will briefly discuss the results of the audit. We did meet with the audit committee back on October 22nd. We did a detailed review of the financial statements. Great questions were asked, covered a lot of areas. So to briefly summarize, district finished the year with good results. Their unassigned fund balance was 4% of their 2018-19 budget, which is compliant with the state regulations and the law of 4%. The district also complied with certain reserves that they have in accordance with general municipal law as well as education law. One of the main reserves that they do have out there, as you may or may not know, in May of 2016, capital reserve of up to $10 million was authorized. They utilized that reserve, and it was actually a transfer of some of that money to capital project funds for the Frank P. Long project. With respect to internal controls, since we do conduct the audit, we do review the internal controls. We did issue what is known as a management letter. That's pretty benign in the sense that The comments are really from the prior year, and the district has issued a corrective action plan to resolve those matters that relate to the internal controls. The last item to really report on is that we still do need to do what is known as a single audit, and that's because the district receives close to $4 million in federal funding. We typically do that, and have historically done that, and finish that in March of 2019. So we'll undergo that process in the next few months and make sure that we complete that before.
Any questions regarding the audit? I know we've sent it in the update. It's available to you today, hard copy, and it's also on board docs as well. Questions, comments?
I know it's a brief summary. Again, we do cover this in detail with the audit committee. Mm-hmm. Are there any questions?
Just a statement or maybe something that you can clarify. You said you had an unmodified opinion.
Yes.
And that there was no corrective action needed.
Not that there's no corrective action needed. On the internal controls, we did have a management letter.
Okay.
So what happens is the district's responsible to create a corrective action plan, which Sam has already done, meaning that they've implemented a process to correct those internal controls.
And that was from last year or this year?
That's last year's. There are some prior comments that have rolled over into the current year, and they're still in the process of being resolved.
Okay.
And that corrective action plan has been updated, and we're seeing some improvement.
It's in the back of the financial statement. It's also item F2 for your approval this evening. So you'll be accepting the auditor's report.
And okay.
I'm sorry, I1 and I2 is the correct measure.
I1 and I2.
Yeah.
Okay. So is it safe to say that we're in good hands with Dr. Burgess?
I would say so. I'd say the district is, as I see it, and I deal with a number of districts, in good shape financially. You have reserves out there, which is good, which means it's healthy, not an overabundance of them, but a nice amount of reserve, which is helpful. Again, you have 4% in your unassigned fund balance, which is the maximum that you're allowed, which is very good. Some districts that we do work with have less than that. So very fortunate. So the management is good.
But and those reserves are all in compliance with the New York State Comptroller's guidelines.
That's correct.
Guidelines.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, then I would say
we will be asking the board to consider the establishing of a repair reserve.
That would be new.
That will be new. Yes.
Okay. And at what's the time frame we would be doing?
We can establish it at any time. We may be asking you on December 5th to establish it. Funding it is something that we'd have to, I believe that's something from the voters.
Okay.
Yes.
So we can require it to funding.
You can establish it, but then you need voter approval.
Okay. Thank you for your time. Any other questions, comments? Thank you for your time, and certainly
thank you
Dr. Burgess, for you and your staff and the fine work that you're doing. Thank you again.
Thank you,
Thank you.
Okay, so our next item for discussion is the first reading of the appendix to the Code of Conduct for Prohibited Gang Activity. This appendix has been developed to clarify and bring more detail to what is prohibited gang-related activity. Back in September, the board reviewed this appendix and had some questions regarding a few of the signs included in the document. Council followed up with the consultant who confirmed the signs have been identified as gang signs, however, not common in our area. The consultant also indicated training, which is scheduled for tomorrow, will address sign identification in the context for which the sign is used. Administration plans to inform parents of the intent of this document and to warn and instruct students of the dangers of gang membership, along with mimicking gang signs and symbols. Therefore, administration recommends this appendix as written and originally submitted and offers it, the document for the board's review and first reading as an appendix to our court conduct.
And so we'll vote on this December 5th meeting? Mm-hmm.
Yes. We will bring it to you for a second meeting and action on December 5th. Any questions, comments, or?
I think it's important to note that this was reviewed by many organizations and professionals that are thoroughly involved with this. And we've said it many times, one of our major priorities is our kids' safety.
And you know, these are the times we're living in, and I think we're taking a very proactive way in many different ways to make sure we're informing our students and our parents about dangers that are a reality for many families and communities, not just us. And I'm grateful that we have the proactive measures taking place where other places are sticking their heads in the sands. And that to me is a step in the right direction because we're proactive. We care about what's going on in this community in a very real way, and taking the proactive measures to seek out advice from professional organizations that deal directly with this, I think is a positive step and a protective step for our kids.
And our plan is to send a letter out to families tomorrow or Friday this week. So they're fully informed of what we're trying to do, mm-hmm. and they're aware of the board's first reading as well as the final reading on December 5th. Okay.
All right, so if anybody has any further comments on it in between meetings, make sure you get those to the superintendent.
Third item? Item three?
Yes.
Okay, in follow-up to Trustee Pacini's request, the administration has reviewed the possibility of funding the fees incurred by families that use My School Bucks, the district's food service payment processing company. We first looked at a partial funding with a number of options. However, each of those options created inefficiencies and actually added labor to our staff with regard to trying to figure it out and keep track of it. Recognizing that the school lunch fund is well-funded, and we will ultimately need to create a plan to spend down the school lunch fund because this is a self-sustaining account. Administration is recommending funding card replenishment transaction fees associated with My School Bucks beginning December 1st and moving forward. It is our hope that this will motivate more families to utilize the payment process, as well as relieve families of the financial burden associated with fees. I offer that for the board's consideration, and actually would like the board to act on that recommendation because we will be expending funds.
Dr. Griffin?
I want to thank Trustee Pacini for bringing this up because I do think it's a really important thing, because I know some families, you can only put so much in, and then each time you hit that amount, the fees you're incurring are in some ways a substantial amount of what you're actually paying for lunches. So I thought that was a great idea, and I really appreciate the fact that you brought this up, because I do think it's a positive step for families to use it, because it is a convenient thing to have, and to have to be punished with a tax, basically, for every time you're using it. So every time that I get the payment thing, I'm like, another few bucks. I mean, it's just a few bucks, but for some families, it is a lot. So I thank you for bringing this up. I think it's a great idea.
I appreciate that. I appreciate the administration for looking into it and making the recommendation, because, you know, I didn't even realize. It always bugged me, but, it was a financial burden for me, so I don't want to make an issue. But when I heard some parents talking about it, and I realized how many parents are sending in checks and sending in kids with cash, and the liabilities of, you know, a kindergartner or a first grader carrying around money, and that adds labor in its own self of somebody taking it and entering it, and the fact that, I think you've heard me say it before, we need to find spots, as difficult it is to cut the budget because of the tax cap and everything else. This is an easy give back, and it doesn't really cost us anything, and it's not even taxpayer money, it's self-sustaining funds. I appreciate everybody's effort in looking into this, and I'm going to be happy to share it with those families that this is a burden for.
All right, so there's no resolution before us, but you would just like a motion?
Yeah, a motion and approval, so we move forward.
So the motion and the approval would be to approve the administration's recommendation for funding the card replenishment transaction fees associated with My School Bucks beginning December 1st.
And so those fees would be going right to the district.
Okay. And everybody understands, as Dr. Gianni said, the fees would go right to the district. Okay? So,
I'd like
would
to make
like
that
to make
motion.
Yes. Mr. Pacini makes the motion. Is there a second? A second by Vice President Hunt. Any further discussion? Seeing no further discussion?
Question.
Oh, yes, sure.
We're approving this. Is this going to be something that we're putting a date on it? Does it end this school year? Is this something that we need to renew each year?
No, we'll just continue doing it. If budgetary reasons cause us to revisit it, then we'll go back to the board and revisit it.
Okay. All right. Seeing no further discussion, all those in favor, please raise your hands. Thank you. Put them down. Seeing all hands raised, the motion carries unanimously. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Administration, moving on to curriculum agenda items. Administration recommends approval of curriculum items reflected in Schedule G1 through G4.
Okay. We need a motion and a second for G1 through 4. Ms. Malin is making a motion, seconded by Dr. Griffin. Any discussion? Seeing no discussion, all those who are in favor, raise your hand. Thank you. Seeing all hands raised, the motion passes unanimously.
And moving along to personnel items, administration recommends approval of personnel changes reflected in Schedules H1 through H7.
Okay. All right, so again, consent agenda item for H1 through 7. Need a motion and a second to approve. Motion by Ms. Malin, seconded by Ms. Hunt. Any discussion? Seeing no discussion, all those in favor, please raise your hands. Thank you. Put them down. All hands raised. Motion carries unanimously. And now we're up to item I.
And business items. Administration recommends approval of business items reflected in Schedules I-1 through I-11.
All right, same thing. I-1 through I-11. Need a motion and a second. Ms. Hunt, seconded by Dr. Griffin. Any discussion? Okay, seeing no discussion, all those in favor, please raise your hands. Thank you very much, put them down. And motion I-1 through I-11 passes unanimously. That brings us up to our final public commentary. No cards. Anybody wishing to speak to the board? Speak now. Okay. And closing remarks, we'll start with Dr. Griffin.
Nothing for me to tell.
All right. And we'll wait for Carly. She does. We do her last. Okay. I got this. Everything good?
Good.
Okay. It was his birthday yesterday, so he thinks for all. Anyway, Miss Santo.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but next week is Thanksgiving, so everyone please have a healthy, happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Ms. Malin? Okay, Ms. Pacini?
No, I'm good, thank you.
Okay. We'll do Ms. Hunt's thank yous, and then I'll close.
Thank you to South Country Education Foundation for the continued support and funding totaling $38,688.39 for their fall grant cycle.
And if I might add to thank Frank Lento, President, for his service. His term is up, and he has actually moved to Florida. But Frank has been more of a friend to South Country schools. And
I just saw him a couple of weeks ago in church.
Gone.
Wow.
Good.
Those are going to be big shoes to fill.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They've always had excellent presidents.
I think he
ends
in January. Yeah. I think January. He's done.
Yeah. And they have limited terms.
Yeah.
Okay, that brings us to the end of our agenda. Just a reminder that the toiletry drive, can you just speak to that?
Sure, South Country Community Leadership Network has an annual toiletry and socks drive. It's coming to a close. I think it's closing. Is it Monday? They're closed Friday. Mm-hmm. But each of our schools have boxes that we're accepting donations that later get donated to both Lighthouse Mission and the local pantry to be included in Thanksgiving Day boxes or bags. So anyone that would like to donate, we're accepting donations at our schools along with the Boys and Girls Club, both local libraries, BHAP.
Mm-hmm. And here they can drive.
And central.
Okay. Might be a nice thing to consider for the holiday season. So also with respect to the audit, just again, congratulations on another successful audit. With respect to what Carly mentioned earlier today, about filling up her water bottle with the new water fountains. Dr. Gurgis, there's a lot of Dr. G's around here. Dr. Gurgis did make mention earlier in the year that our water fountains, actually I think it was on the tour, when we did the building tour before we opened schools, that our water fountains now have the refillable access for the refilling water bottles, and they count how many water bottles we save, plastic water bottles we save, from going into the landfills. And so when I visited Brookhaven Elementary School, I took a picture of it, but I don't recall what the number was, but it was up there. So perhaps, I've asked this of you before, but I didn't hold your feet to the fire on it.
I'll get a count.
Thank you. So we'll have a count for the update, because I think that's significant. We have to, you know, we're taking responsibility. We made some changes here so that we're not using water bottles at our board meetings. We're using the water pitchers, and I think the effort that we're making in the schools is certainly not only saving money, but is being kind to the environment. So we should praise ourselves for taking that initiative and see what we're actually doing. All right. And then in closing, yesterday was our superintendent's birthday, so I would just like everybody to just give a nice round of applause, wishing. We're going to steer it here to sing to you, or rather my music teacher. So I will spare you singing.
Thank you.
The Kramer Kingdom.
We'll have the Kingdom back. And the Kingdom got mentioned in the Center of Excellence. I did include them in my speech because they left such an impression on me, and I'm sure all of us. That's all we have. Just to echo what Mr. Santo said earlier, everybody have a very happy, healthy, and safe Thanksgiving season. And without further ado, we'll take a motion to adjourn. Motion by Ms. Malin, seconded by Ms. Hunt. All those in favor, we stand adjourned before the students have to leave for their 8:30.
Stick around, you guys will have to stay.
A little bit.
What was the name of the teacher?